I am Asees Singh and I am from New Delhi. Today, I will take you on a journey to the dark dimensions that Edward and Richard follow to meet the light. You do know, mate, we are in a graveyard. Why would we go down an old trapdoor which is right next to it? Edward shrilled as breath vapor came out from his mouth. As he spoke in that quiet graveyard of Bramfordshire. Ah, it's all right, matey. No one visits the dark corners of the town this late. And plus, this graveyard was built on an old castle ground. Perhaps it may have some riches to give. Edward was still apprehensive about it. He had never seen an apparition himself, but had heard of them visiting people at the darkest hours of the day. Oh, leave it, dear Edward. Go prick thy face and overhead thy fare. Thou lily livered boy. Feeling humiliated and invigorated, Edward brushed Richard off to the side and started to descend the old chip steps. Richard followed suit and both descended into the flight of stairs that can only be described as leading to a dark chasm of nothing. Why do you make me do such things, Edward? You do know right, my family has nothing. These machines and everything. They've taken my job away from me and my life. And neither is that old slouch Victoria doing a thing. She's just working for her sons, Edward and the others. She's royalty, Edward. You must not say such derogatory words. It's a heinous crime. Nobody's hearing what I'm saying in the dark, eerie, yet peaceful place. Agreed, Edward. You're here for the treasure, it seems. Sure am, Richard. Sure am. As the conversation came to a halt, so did the stairs. They reached the end of the stairs where they saw solid ground. Ah, it seems someone has built something here. Perhaps a dungeon. Don't get ahead of yourself, Edward. Light the lamp. The light of the lamp illuminated the path ahead. They walked into what seemed like an old dungeon of stone with ornate works hung on the walls. The sound of their steps echoed in the ears, which supported by an eerie sound made by something like a bat squeal. Bats don't live underground, do they? No, not as per me. They continued walking down and Richard felt something touch him on his shoulders. Too fair to look back, he continued walking forward. These beams, these tools, why are they here? Thought Richard as he looked around him while walking. Suddenly, he slipped on a liquid. Edward ran to get him up. Oh, crikey, how did you fall? I slipped on something. Is anything wet around here? No. I can't see a damn thing, you clown. You can't even walk straight. Brushing his clothes off, Edward and Richard paced forth. Within a few yards, their path ended onto a fork. Left or right? Right, as I'm always right. Feeling an ardent desire to knock his comrade out, Richard walked into the arch on the right as he saw some rays fall onto the path up ahead. Following him was Edward. As they paced forth, they came to an open room. Suddenly, they heard some noises. Someone screaming in pain, a loud growl, as if a minotaur was breathing the same air as them. But something in Richard's heart pulled him towards those noises. Was it the kindness in him, or was it the pain of losing his wife? Was it the misanthropy of his own that had changed him, or was it his own philanthropy? Whatever it was, Richard ran towards those noises. Edward followed him, thinking it was a gimmick of some sorts. But what they encountered was nothing short of terrifying. A cyclops, with his only eye having a very small eyeball and his large slash deformed body, stood in front of a lady who was bleeding, with the cyclops slashing her body with a sickle. When Richard saw the face of the lady, his spine went cold. Emily, her wife, stretched out her hand, asking for help for her husband, who was petrified by the sight. Without second guessing, Richard leapt into the action, trying to control the armed Cretan cyclops. Edward followed suit, as he and Emily shared a past not known to Richard. They fought till their last breath, which came a few seconds after they started, as a Cyclops squeezed their legs dry. Richard felt immense pain, but it was soon replaced by an eternal, peaceful light. Ah, this sounds like a tragic yet typical end for the tale of Richard and Edward, right? Brave warriors they were, lost to the ravages of monstrosity. But were they lost? If they were, who is writing this incident that occurred in an abandoned dungeon with such detail? Why would I tell you who I am? I'm not in a state to say anything. Slashed and squeezed by that freak, just to save a lady who had double-crossed me with my money-hungry friend. You shall know who I am when the light shall illuminate your soul, when my blood is touched upon by a mortal. Then, and only then, you shall know who died in that dungeon, Richard or me. Thank you.